So what are we talking today? Well, today we're talking growth versus value stocks. Stay connected. Oye, what's popping everyone? Welcome to my channel. My name is Peter. I'm a certified investor, personal finance enthusiast. I'm also an IT professional. And on this channel, Game of Finance, we talk about all things personal finance, investing, economy, retirement, and of course, mindset. So make sure you like, subscribe, comment, notification bell. That way you don't miss out any of my fresh content, all right? So now without further ado, let's get this work. Cool beans, let's go. And guys, here on Game of Finance TV, we're trying to bring positive change to inspire, help, learn, share ideas, growth and good leadership. So please stay safe and stay healthy. All right, cool beans. Hey guys, so again, we're talking growth versus value stocks. So right away, you know, weighing in on the merits of these two investment styles, it's like choosing between, you know, your favorite movies, your favorite song, artists, even superheroes. For me, if I take the simple and humble analogy of ice cream, you know, I love chocolate and vanilla. So I gotta have both, all right? So, you know, in this case for both growth and value stocks, you know, they could maximize value for investors. But the two methods of investing, they take different approach, guys. You have to pay attention to that. It's major key. You know, a lot of investors are often confused about the difference between growth stocks and value stocks. Okay, so the main way in which they differ is not about how they bought and sold, you know, or nor it is how much, you know, ownership they represent in a company, but rather the basic element that, you know, different that lies mainly in the way in which they are, you know, perceived by the market and of course us as investors. That's the major key, guys. So, and again, guys, you know, when referring to growth and value, you know, these are two type of schools that you need to learn both of their fundamentals when it comes to investing in securities. Neither approach, you know, is guaranteeing you or anybody to provide appreciation in the stock market, you know, or the value. Both carry investment risk. Whether you pick the value section or the growth section, it don't matter. You know, you gotta understand the differences between growth and value investing, guys. It will help you decide which may be the, you know, the best and appropriate path for you to reach your specific goals. You know, the best way is just to study both sides. That way you can find the right place and situation, because maybe, you know, it might be beneficial for you to actually have both, you know, the growth and the value on stocks on your portfolio, what they call the blending, you know. So this tactic may help you manage risk and potentially enhance your returns over time. So the major key for this, it will be educating yourself. It's that simple. You have to keep that fundamental always active. All right, guys. So now we're going to be focusing here on the board to dig a little bit deeper about the definitions and clarifications. All right. Now let's touch base about the growth versus stocks value and what they represent and some of the example as far as the companies. All right. So yellow section right here, growth versus value stocks. Some examples real quick. We have 10, and I'm pretty sure some way somehow you have heard about this company. So let's begin with the growth section. So Amazon, Tesla, Facebook, Google, and Netflix. Those are the, and you can actually consider those are the top dogs when it comes to growth stocks, all right? So next, we're gonna be focusing on value. What are some of the value stocks? Very simple. Microsoft, Pepsi, 3M, Intel, and another monster, Apple. These are the value stocks right here. They offer dividends, you know. So that's the definition and the attachment when it comes to growth and value. All right. Okay, guys. So continuing right here in this section, this blue dot right here. All right. We're going to focus on the growth stocks first. Amazon, Tesla, Facebook, Google, and Netflix. They are often characterized by companies with significant cash flow or earnings that seek to grow at a rate much greater than the overall market. Yes, that's a major key right there. What are some of the characteristics? Well, strong growth rate and typically a high PE ratio. The next characteristic is going to be, well, generally they do not pay dividend in most cases, but rather they reinvest the earnings to accelerate growth, which makes sense. You know, that way you will see the increase in capital gains, guys. That's what it means. So that's another way for us investors to increase our personal wealth. Got it? All right. Oh, but this is major key right here. One of the characteristics for the growth stocks is going to be they are more risky. So that's something to keep in mind. This section here, the more risky, it just comes with the territory. It's just part of the game, all right? Even though these companies right here, they're big, they have a strong balance sheet, they still present a higher risk, all right? So make sure you keep that in mind. Cool beans? So now, moving to the next section. It's going to be the value stocks. Right here again with the Microsoft, Pepsi, 3M, Intel, and Apple, all right? So we're going to be touching this section here, green dot, so follow me. Oh, value stocks. They are characterized by companies with solid fundamentals that are trading below their book value. Sometimes you're going to see the lingo is going to be referring to undervalue. That's why I have it right here. Okay, what are some of the characteristics? Well, strong fundamentals, typically higher price, and offer dividends. All right, dividends. I love dividends. They often share earnings with investors through, doesn't matter, through bull market and the bear market. As we see right now during the pandemic, there are some great companies that are still offering dividend, and there's some companies actually even increasing their dividend, which is crazy. And that's what we love to hear. We love to hear companies that they stepping up their game and say, hey, nah, we're good. We're gonna support our shareholders, and we're even going to increase the dividend. That's what we want to hear as investors. Next one. Well, they generally have low price to earnings ratio. And the other major key here, compared to the growth stocks, they are less risky. And this is because they are focused on the stable, the premium section, you know. When it comes to the growth and the value stocks, for me, my investing style is to have both, so I can have the ingredients and the action of increasing capital gains, but still have this maintaining section. If by any chance there's some sort of a recession, I can still receive my dividends without the company, you know, taking a dip or a hit that is going to affect maybe removing those dividends. We don't want that, so that's major key, less risky, all right, guys? And guys, quick tip. I know I mentioned about staples, yes, but I'm not only referring about Walmart or Procter & Gamble, you know, 3M, things like that, because as you can see here, value stock, there's Microsoft, Intel, and Apple, which are tech companies. The reason I say staple for me is because of their business model. Is so huge that even if there's some sort of a recession, a dip, a contraction, because of the business model, they able to maintain and create some sort of a defensive status. So that's what I'm referring about the staples, you know, as far as the definition and clarification. Okay, so I'm hoping that you understand that. Just want to bring that clarification real quick, okay? All right, guys. So, referring about this section here, the blue one. Two schools of investing. They have two common ratios, all right? So, let's talk about them. The first one is going to be price to earnings. You're going to see this a lot, big time, in every account, period. Let's begin. No. Oh, this is a company's stock price divided by earnings per share. That simple. That's the definition of price to earnings, okay? So now for the next one, it's going to be price to book value. Again, you're gonna see this a lot, especially if you're looking for the value stocks. No, this is the stock price divided by the stated value of its net assets. Now, major key, guys, or total assets less intangible assets and liabilities. That's what it means when you're referring to, or when we are referring to, about price to book value when it comes to the value stocks, and price to earnings when it comes to growth stocks. Okay, all right, guys, ready for the next level? Here we go. Growth versus value stocks. What is that primary and fundamental process that you must have when it comes to investing? Told you guys, mindset. Oh, right here, this red dot. Let's begin. Nope. Which style you might favor generally has to do with your objectives, risk tolerance, and investment horizon, guys. That is major key. That's why I have it right here, parenthesized. Okay, that's major key. You must recognize those three fundamentals. If by any chance you change your overall investing plan, make sure that you keep those parameters in check. You know, I'm pretty sure you have heard this before. Check yourself before you wreck yourself. Yes, definitely. You need to make sure that you have your objectives, risk tolerance, and investing horizon in check. And guys, that applies to whichever method you pick from the two schools, or if you want to combine them, whether you have growth, and later you pick or choose value stocks, or if you decide to do the blending method. Regardless of which one, it's imperative that you keep yourself in check, making sure that you recognize your objectives, risk tolerance, and investment horizons. Cool beans? Okay, guys, moving along to food for thoughts. Right there, a little bonus to summarize all the growth versus value stocks, okay? Let's begin. This blue section here, growth stocks. So, element, expensive, or sometimes very expensive, okay? Stock prices are high relative to their sales or profits. This could be due to expectations from investors of higher sales or profits in the future, okay? Next element, riskier. Investors expect big things, but if growth plans don't come to fruition, the price of the stock or the security to plummet. It happens to all of them. Even actually, this could also apply to value stocks. You know, something like this happens, the stock will go down, you know, regardless. I've seen it with technology stocks, even though they are actually in the value school. So this could apply to both sides. So make sure that you keep that in mind for the growth stocks. All right, so moving along. Now, moving along to the green dot right here, guys. So value stocks, okay? Whoa. Element, less expensive, okay? Stock price are low relative to their sales and profit, similar to the growth stocks, what I said a few seconds ago, okay? Less riskier. They have already proven an ability to generate profits based on proven business model. That's what I love. Next one, stock appreciation is not guaranteed, guys. But then again, this applies to even growth stocks. Appreciation is not guaranteed. That's why I always said you have to keep in mind for the risk and the rewards. Cool beans? All right, so make sure that you keep that in mind. You know, when a company has already a proven track record, it brings, a higher peace of mind. And that's what we want as investors. So we can put our hard-earned money into a company that is trustworthy. Okay, cool beans? All right, guys. Hope you find this content valuable. Please practice due diligence. Do your homework. That way you know and recognize your risk and your rewards. You need to educate yourself. So if you have any questions or comments, please put them down below, okay? I also want to share my Investing 101 guide. It's right in the description. Just click on the link, submit your name, email, it'll take you straight to the download. It's free, so there's no excuse. Cool beans. And also, for my Latin Spanish people, I got you. All right, same process. Nombre, correo electrónico, cliquen y lo llevará al sitio web y ahí podrán bajar estudio guía. So así se pueden educarse y ponerse al día. Es completamente gratis. So no hay excusa, okay? Pónganse para lo suyo, okay? Make sure you like, comment, subscribe, hit that notification bell, alright? That's the Call of Duty formulas. Don't forget. Anyway, guys, I appreciate your time. Thank you for watching. I hope you have a great day. And I see all of you on the next chapter, okay? So make sure you work hard, but also work smart. I'm out.